Hello guys, good afternoon. Welcome to my channel. So today is a very special episode because we are going to break my 25th hour fast. So we've been fasting for 25 hours together with my mom, who is holding the video right now. And for this episode of breaking a fast, it's very special because we are eating vegetarian. Yes, you've heard that right. Vegetarian or even vegan, because it is purely plant-based but still adhering to low carbohydrate diet or low carbohydrate meals. So what do we have here? So we have here a Vietnamese soup, just the soup, but all you have here are just cabbage. We also have ginisang kimchi. So it's kimchi on pet chai. So it's more vegetables here. And for our protein source, we have a mix of peanuts and almonds cooked in adobo. So if you can see that, so that is adobo complete with onions, garlic, also spices and vinegar and toyo. So this is a low carb and at the same time vegan, and most of our fat source here are coming from the nuts and also coconut oil. So all of these has coconut oil. And for our dessert, of course, we have our own homemade chocolate peanut butter that is sugar-free with some few pieces of raisins and dark chocolate. So we will feast here, but before that, we are going to take our supplements, which are mostly electrolytes. So all of these are salt-loaded. Yes, it has a lot of salt because sodium is the most abundant electrolytes in our body that is excreted all throughout the day. So especially when you are on low carb, the insulin that is holding the sodium, usually in most people, it will no longer hold sodium or salt. So it will be excreted, and it is not a bad thing. It's just that we need to take more salt than usual. So this one has salt, this one kimchi is also very salty, and this soup also has salt, okay? And these peanut butter are actually made from roasted salted peanuts, which we made ourselves. And for the second most important electrolyte, it is magnesium. So I would like to give that an emphasis that we have to take magnesium supplements because we cannot take it in most of our foods. And in our body, there are more than 300 processes that needs magnesium in order for it to be successful. And research show that lack of magnesium or magnesium deficiency is even linked to cardiovascular disease. So yes, lack of magnesium has a lot of impact to our lives. The most common signs and symptoms would be frequent cramps, frequent muscle pains, and muscle spasms. And it is because before, in the olden times, in the times of our ancestors, the hunters and gatherers, magnesium is very rich and can be found in our water, the natural water sources, the waterfalls, the lakes, the spring, and all those. It has a lot of magnesium naturally. But because of our modernization and filtration process, especially the steel pipes where our water is coursing before coming to our homes, magnesium content in our water right now is very, very low. That is why we have to take in magnesium as a supplement. So this is just a supplemental dose, around 400 milligram per day. And also, we also take potassium, but not often. Maybe once every 2 to 3 days we take it. But most importantly, we have to take sodium, because when your sodium or salt in the body is normal, you are also preserving your potassium in your body. But from time to time, over time, it can be depleted. So you can just add potassium. But if you don't have problem, and especially you're eating variety of foods, you don't need to take this. And additionally, you can also add zinc. So any brand supplements that are available in your favorite health shops, you can just add that. So this one, we are going to have a feast. I hope you get to know about magnesium, you get to have it more in your system because it has been shown to be protective for cardiovascular diseases such as heart attacks and even stroke. So that would be all for now. Thank you very much. Till our next video. Bye-bye.